Hey everybody, nice to have you here. This is going to be a Bobbi Brown makeup haul. Do you ever get like this unusual urge to just find out more about a particular makeup brand? Because that's kind of what went down here for me. When it comes to Bobbi Brown makeup, I have used, actually going back quite a while, like towards the beginning of my channel, I remember trying Bobbi Brown's corrector way back then, and her creamy concealer and the foundation stick, and then I really like stopped there. And even though I liked those products, for whatever reason, I just didn't explore much more into the line. And I think sometimes with brands that you're not super familiar with, it can feel kind of overwhelming, like you're not really sure where to begin, or, you know, I'd want to try all the eyeshadows, so where would I even start? And for quite a while now, I've really been wanting to try a Bobbi Brown shimmer brick, so I just decided, hey, now's the time, it's gonna happen. So I have some face products, some eye products, and some lip products to talk to you about today. It's not purely just a haul, like here's what I got type video, because I have been playing around with these things for a few days. So first thing I'll mention, I feel like I've been a little bit out of the powder foundation game for a while. Like, I've tried a lot of interesting drugstore powder foundations, a couple maybe here and there that I've liked from high-end brands like IT Cosmetics, but overall I haven't done a lot of experimentation. And I know that when I think about the Emily Awards, and that's when I always kind of review, okay, what have I tried? What's been the best? And I just haven't really put myself out there to try enough, I don't think. So I got a Bobbi Brown powder foundation. This is called the Skin Weightless Powder Foundation. Please excuse all of the fingerprints that have developed over all of these products already. But this weightless powder foundation, I got it in the shade Beige 3. And you got your mirror in there. There's your powder and a sponge. The powder definitely is a good color tone for my skin. It feels soft, but not maybe quite as like buttery creamy as I was expecting, but that's okay. It doesn't mean it's not going to do a good job. And today, you know, I have on a liquid foundation and I use some of this over the top. So I feel like I'm getting a nicely sort of mattified look. I've got a little glow in certain areas where I wanted it, and I used other products to do that. I'd used this the other day also kind of like a setting powder, and I did feel like my makeup looked really fresh and had good staying power even like late into the day. So from that perspective, I like it. I haven't used it yet solely as powder foundation. That's the thing that I'm always like a little hesitant to do for whatever reason, but I'm gonna try it that way and definitely see if it's got decent enough coverage when it's worn just by itself or just on top of concealer in a few places where you wanna wear it. I'm definitely gonna use it that way too. Now, I got a couple of the Pot Rouge for lip and cheeks. You guys know I love a good multitasker, so the fact that these products can be worn on your lips and your cheeks, that appeals to me. But also, little backstory here. You ever start browsing the internet and you wind up looking at something after a period of time and you're like, how did I get here? It was kind of that way for me when I wound up watching Marie Osmond's live makeup application on Facebook. I'm like, oh wow, you know, this is interesting. I'm really fascinated when performers, people who are, you know, really heavily in the public eye, celebrities, do their own makeup. That is super fascinating to me. Like, maybe that's part of my infatuation. Well, I know it is. Part of my infatuation with Carrie Underwood is the fact that she said when she's on tour, she does her own makeup, and I really respect and love that. Anyway, Marie Osmond was sitting there doing her makeup before a show, I guess, and I was really impressed with how she was just like kind of slapping stuff on, using her fingers most of the time, and stuff was looking fabulous. And a couple of the things she used were these particular shades of the Pot Rouge, and she was using them as blushes. And so it's Milk Chocolate and Fresh Melon were the shades that I got. So happy with this. Probably never would have thought to try this had I not seen it in action on someone first. So this is a creamy product. There's no shimmer in it. And yeah, it can work just like a cream blush. You can dab it on your lips for a little color there. But this shade has a lot of brown in it and a little bit of some dusty rose. What it really reminds me of, I think a very accurate description, is this is like Benefits Dallas boxed powder, but in a cream form, because it has that little, you know, dusty plum, dusty rose thing happening. It's not like a pure, strong brown, but it's got a lot lot of neutral happening. So I actually, the other day I did use it with my fingers and it was okay that way, but this isn't necessarily like the silkiest product. Some really dry down quickly on the skin. This is really a cream with some moisture in it. So I prefer pulling out my e.l.f. small stipple brush because I can really control the application. And I just went kind of right in this zone. Right down in here is where I applied it, just sort of above where I might do a contour, and I really liked it. I think you could definitely lay this product on heavy enough to where you would feel a little bit of stickiness on the skin, but if you're using a brush like this, it keeps the application like super light. So I really enjoyed that shade. I think I'm gonna get tons of use out of it because it's very versatile, very buildable, and I love the color of the true Benefit Dallas. I did a little comparison to the regular Dallas and the Cheekathon palette in my last video that I put up, and this definitely reminds me of original Dallas, but in a cream. Then the other shade that I got is Fresh Melon, and this is more of like the little fresh pop on the apple of the cheek. This shade is rather light. I'll swatch it here next to the Milk Chocolate shade. You can see how light I'm talking about there. I haven't tried these on the lips yet. They actually might be really pretty like blended on the lips, but the Fresh Melon, while I think it's really pretty, it's a little less remarkable to me than the Milk Chocolate shade. I still think I'll use it, but I do believe I have quite a few things already in my collection that are this peachy tone in a cream format. You know, I've kind of got that covered. Happy I tried it, but extra happy with the other shade. Now let's talk about the Shimmer Brick that I got. Well, I felt like I wanted a Shimmer Brick for a long time. I really have not honed in on a particular one. It's like I just want to feel the formula, try it out. I don't really care what shade. They all look really pretty to me. And I do have several of the Physicians Formula shimmer strips, but those all come in kind of a golden bronzy. They're meant to be like bronzers, basically. So I feel like I've got that bronzy color family covered in this type of product. So I wanted to go with something that was more like the shade of a blush, so I got Nectar. Isn't it beautiful? It's so, so pretty. These gorgeous tones that you can mix together. You could definitely focus in on maybe just one part of it. I think if you get your brush more toward the top of the compact, you end up with a lighter shade simply because there's this kind of whitish iridescent peach strip happening up in there. And then you get more of like that solid blush tone down in the bottom. But I really, really like this. I think it's beautiful. If you mix them all together, it's like the lightest peach but very glowy look. Definitely blush and highlight rolled into one is what this product makes me think of. And I am wearing this kind of right on top of where I did the Fresh Melon shade on my cheeks. I took it up in here a bit and the glow is just beautiful. I feel like whenever I've worn this, I felt so just fresh as a daisy, you know, like it's so beautiful and glowy but with just the right amount of color mixed in. I know they had a pink and the bronze, and I'm not sure what all other colors. Let me know. Let's start the discussion. What ones of these do you have? What do you love? But I am really, really impressed with the peachy glow of Nectar. Looking at my box here, I also got this full-size hydrating eye cream, but this was just a bonus. This was just thrown in. I ordered off of BobbyBrownCosmetics.com. I don't know if there was a promotion going on and I missed it, but I was really surprised to open my box and find a full-size hydrating eye cream. So I am wearing that today. It says enriched mineral water and aloe vera. So I put it on today under my makeup. It's really nice. Was not expecting that, but thank you. So with eye products, I was really a little bit overwhelmed as I was looking at all the different eyeshadows because at least when you're shopping on the Bobbi Brown Cosmetics website, they've got them kind of divided up. Like the mattes are in one section, then all of the shimmer finishes are in another, the metallic finishes. And I actually kind of appreciate that because there's no question as to what the shadow finish is going to be. You know what you're getting. And first and foremost, I landed on a shade, and this was kind of by chance. I didn't really know that it would be perfect for this, but I believe I have the perfect shadow for a one shadow look. And I hold it up here and it's like what is that kind of medium brown color? This is the metallic eyeshadow in Burnt Sugar. First off, I think metallic, that word could be used a little bit loosely with some of these shadows because it does have sheen and shimmer, but it's definitely not like the nearly wet look that some really metallic eyeshadows have, you know? So I wouldn't necessarily see this as a pure metallic shadow. But what it is kind of like a mix of taupe and brown and a little bit of some golden sheen in there. And I think it's absolutely dynamite as a one shadow look. So I had to try the one shadow look today. I worked in a few of the other shadows yesterday. Really liked that look. I'll pop up a picture later on as we go and show you how those look, but I just had to see, you know, exactly what this was capable of when used purely on its own. So I've got this shade patted all over the lid. I blended it up into the crease, and I love the intensity. I really love the intensity of all of the shades that I have. They really are super pigmented, and I feel like I'm getting a lot of product, but I patted it all over the lid with like a Sonia Kashuk medium shadow brush into the crease with a Sigma E25, and I love what's happening as the shade shears out. You see that kind of goldeny bronze. And then I did a pencil brush just all down in here on the lower lash line. Absolutely love it. Like, this is such an easy shadow to work with. It could be your everyday, just quick and easy look. It could be kind of a special nighttime type look too. So I love Burnt Sugar. That's definitely like the star standout, I think, of what I have, at least so far in my just first few days of using them. Now, also in the metallic formula, I got Cognac, and I was wearing this one a little bit yesterday, kind of smudged into the crease. It goes a little bit darker than Burnt Sugar. It's kind of interesting how these are called metallic, and I don't think they're that shiny. And that's fine by me. I think they're more versatile not being quite so shimmery, but it's just funny that they're called metallic. And I feel like this shade is just so gorgeous because it's got a little bit of red in it, a little bit of burgundy, but also a lot of just dark brown. Okay, there's the Burnt Sugar. There's the Cognac next to it. You can see a little bit of shine, but not too much. And I thought that looked really pretty as a crease color. This could maybe be an interesting one shadow look as well. I'll have to try that because it's just not too terribly dark, but just enough darkness to really give, I think, a potentially dramatic look. I feel like I'm talking about these in order of my preference of the eyeshadows that I got. I got one of the mattes, and this is in the shade called Black Plum. I did a little bit of like eyeliner smudging with this, but haven't worn it so much as an all-out eyeshadow yet. But yeah, who doesn't love a nice dark plum? And as I put my finger in this, it feels to me a lot like my Vizart matte shades. You know, there's a little dryness to it, but yet you swatch it out and it's extremely pigmented. So I've got that one right down here. It's very dark. I will say it's kind of hard to pick up on a lot of the plumminess in that color. I feel like once I put this into an eye look, it could pass for dark brown. It could pass for almost black or charcoal. You know, it's just one of those really deep dark shades. Now, the last shade that I got, this was the one that I actually thought was going to be a pretty one shadow look, and it still might, but I think it's maybe going to be a little light for that. It was in the shimmer wash category, and it's the shade called Rose Gold, and it's a very light pinky rose gold. You know how some tend to go a little bit more toward peach or kind of a more of a brassy look? This to me comes off more just like light shimmery pink, and it's pretty, and I do think I'll get use out of it. And isn't that a pretty like foursome lineup of shades right there? But I don't think that's my favorite thing that I own that's classified as rose gold. Like, I'm thinking of all the pretty shadows in the Loraca Zipped palette, you know, that have that pretty like little bit of bronze, little bit of gold, little bit of pink in it. This one, it feels nice. It feels like a really good formula, but that particular shade just isn't wowing me. The two shades that are really impressing me are the Burnt Sugar and the Cognac, and I am going to try that one as a one shadow look too. But part of what I like about these shadows is as you start like kind of smudging away the swatches, look how nicely they stay, especially the dark color. Like, that really adheres to the skin somehow, so I'm really impressed with that. Last couple things, I wanted to try some lip products, and I wound up with two shades that I think are pretty close to one another. Like, it's kind of a fine line between them. I didn't plan it that way, but that's just the way it worked out. I got one of her regular lip colors, so classic Bobbi Brown lipsticks, and this is in the shade Pink Mauve, and that's what I've been wearing throughout the video. That deep, dusty berry type color. I definitely like it. I don't know that I find the formula of this lipstick to be that, like, wow, it's so different from anything else I've used. It just feels like a very classic lipstick. It's creamy with no shimmer. I'll definitely use it, but I'm not, like, doing cartwheels over it. The other shade that I got is one of the creamy lip colors. So you can see the packaging is different here. It doesn't have that gold band around it. And when you open it up, instead of being like a formed pointed tip bullet, it's more of a rounded, like kind of like a Revlon lip butter type style. This shade, Italian Rose, is kind of close to what I have on, except it's a little lighter and a little bit warmer. But the formula, I think, is outstanding. I love the way this feels. Little bit of thickness, very rich on the lips. But it's so, so comfortable. It just makes you want to smush your lips together, press them together, and just go, ooh, it feels so good. And you can do that, and it doesn't smush the color off of your lips, you know. It actually still stays looking good. So I'm going to take off what I've got on there currently and put this other shade on for you. Oh, it's just so creamy. Good amount of shine. It just feels tremendous as you rub your lips together. Like, it's a really luxurious feeling lipstick. And this is, of course, the kind of shade that you could rock anytime, anywhere. If I really would have realized how close the two lip color shades were that I got, I probably would have gotten a different color in the regular lipstick, but I'm really happy with this Italian Rose shade in the creamy lipstick. So yeah, overall, I think a really successful Bobbi Brown haul. I'm kind of looking around to see what are the things that I like best. I would say the biggest hits for me would be the Shimmer Brick. I was not let down by the beauty of the Shimmer Brick. Really excited about the Milk Chocolate Lip and Cheek Pot Rouge. Very impressed with the eyeshadow formulas as a whole, but most happy with Burnt Sugar and Cognac is a close second. And the Creamy Lip Color is a definite winner as well. Everything else, you know, I certainly like it, but I just don't know that it's really maybe had a chance to stand out to me a whole lot just yet. The Powder Foundation, I think, remains to be seen how that's going to work as an actual powder foundation. So we'll keep trying, but thank you guys so much for watching. I hope this was fun for you. Please let me know what kinds of things you've tried and enjoyed from this line, or if there's any other makeup brands that you feel like I haven't really dug into enough that you'd like to see me use more products from. I'd be happy to hear. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon. Bye.